I think the magic of the Himalayas is that one grows up really feeling the forces of nature and of divinity. The backbone of society and the people who really bear the brunt of the physical hardship of living in the hills are the women. The entire responsibility of looking after the home, the children, the fields, the elders, all of that falls on the women. They're the first to wake up and the last to sleep. And that is a life of drudgery and monotony. The initial vision of Panchachuli was to give the women a creative occupation, which would also bring them an income. We started with 5 women in a room in the house of Muni Mehta. And after 6 months, Muni Mehta said that she had a list of over 400 women who wanted to enroll into the program.
हमने उसका कारपेट शुरू करा कारपेट के छोटे छोटे आसन बना करके मैडम ने स्कूल को डोनेशन दिया उनको कि तुम लोग स्कूल के बच्चों को बैठने को दिया उसके बाद धीरे धीरे हमारे दिमाग में काम आया कि औरतें चरखे में अच्छा ऊन काटने लगी अच्छा काम करने लगी तो हम लोगों ने एक लूम शुरू
We started with the local markets in the villages and then slowly the markets expanded and grew and today Panchachuli is known for its exquisite handlooms. In June 2013, there was a huge disaster in the Kedarnath area, which is 200 kilometers away from where Panchachuli Women Weavers operates. Every year, thousands upon thousands of pilgrims from all over the country come and trek up this very narrow valley to pay obeisance to the Kedarnath shrine. What happened was unprecedented and unseasonal torrential rains. And these rains caused a flash flood above the Kedarnath temple. And in this flash flood, thousands of people were washed away. There are many women who have lost their husbands, who don't have any other source of income, and who have to raise single-handedly 2 to 4 children.
आपदा में जो हमारे साथ हुआ है उससे तो बहुत उस समय तो बहुत असंभव था खड़े होने में बहुत दिक्कत आती थी
We had a meeting in Panchachuli about this and some of the women said it's not good enough to give money what we should give is our skills So then they committed themselves to actually going to those remote villages in the Kedar Valley and teaching the women.
बड़ी बड़ी बुढ़िया माताएं जो थी वो भी बेसहारा हुई की थी और रो रहे थे उनको देख के हमको काफी दुख हुआ वहां जाके और हमने उनको वहां जाके किसी ने कढ़ाई सिखाई किसी ने बुनाई सिखाई मैंने पेंटिंग सिखाई और किसी ने बुनकर सिखाया किसी ने चरखा सिखाया
Immediately after the floods there was complete closing in to themselves and not wanting to open up and the only thing that actually made them open up was the fact that they were working with their hands and the collective effort of many women sitting together and doing this brought slowly a change in the spirit
बहुत अच्छा लगता है और आगे बच्चों का भी जो भी यहां पे सैलरी मिलती है
17, 18, 19. The success of Mandakini of having established and created an entity in a very remote and disaster-struck area was something which resonated with women across the high mountain valleys of Uttarakhand. These people started approaching us and saying, we would also like to be part of this. And that is what inspired us to set up a center of excellence for weaving, which is going to be the hub for all the weavers of Uttarakhand. their products are going to many different countries in the world. So they feel that they're connected with something much larger than just their region. It's about time for women all over the world to bring up positive, creative, constructive energies just by, you know, bringing out their own feminine spirit.
Oh.